Now moving towards the introduction. Data mining is a process to discover the knowledge or the hidden patterns from the large databases. The overall goal of data mining is to extract the useful information from the database and transfer that useful information into an understandable format that can be used for future prediction. It is used by many organizations like business intelligent organizations, financial analysts, marketing organization and companies with a strong customer focus like retail, financial and communication. There are a lot more other applications like in medical field it can be used, in crime analysis it can be used and many more. Now about the KDD process of data mining, that is a knowledge discovery in database process. The first step in KDD process is the collection or the gathering of data. Data can be collected from many sources. Like we have data warehousing or the databases offline or online, there are so many modes of collecting the data. After that, the second step is the data cleaning. Data cleaning is to eliminate the bogus data, or you can say that the null data or some kind of error from the data set. The third step is the feature extraction. It includes basically extracting the relevant data or the best or the optimized feature, extracting those kinds of important features from the data. The fourth step is the pattern extraction or the discovery. This step consists of the data mining techniques, like we will use some kind of machine learning algorithms in order to extract the information from that collected data. Then is visualization of the data. Visualization of data and evaluation of the result. The pattern or the extraction of the pattern that can be discovered using the data mining process, those patterns are basically used as a knowledge base for the analysis of the future prediction. After that, classification. Classification is basically a technique of data mining that is used to classify each item or each instance into a predefined set or a group of sets or a group of classes. Like we have in case of this sentiment analysis, we have two or three class labels. Like we have positive sentiment, negative sentiment and neutral sentiment. Those positive, negative and neutral are basically considered as the classes. The goal of classification is to accurately predict the target class for each item in the data. That means we have to basically predict the target class for each and every instance or for each and every review of the movie. For example, a classification model could be used to identify loan applicants as low, medium or high credit risk. Like here we have three class labels, that is a low, medium or high credit risk. The simplest type of classification problem is binary classification. Binary classification, in this kind of classification we have only two possible values. We have only two possible values. For example, high credit rating or low credit rating. Now in multi-class targets we have more than two values. Like here we have explained low, medium or high credit, and also like we have explained in our case we have three sentiment analysis, that is a positive, negative and neutral. After that, going to explain you what is basically the sentiment analysis. Sentiment analysis is a subdomain of opinion mining where the analysis is focused on the extraction of emotions and opinion of the people towards a particular topic. That means sentiment analysis basically focus on the emotions or the opinions of the people towards some kind of topic. Like in our application we have considered the movies review. By reviewing or by taking the reviews of movies, a person can show their emotion, like that movie is good, bad or any kind of mixed feeling, like the neutral. Sentiment analysis aims to determine the attitude of a speaker or a writer with respect to some topic. It basically shows how the speaker or the writer is basically thinking about that topic. The attitude may be his or her judgment or the evaluation of the affective state or the intended emotional communication. The affective state is basically the emotional state of author when he is writing. And the intended emotional communication is the emotional effect that author wishes to have on the reader. Like in case of review, when the author has written some kind of view, what kind of effect he basically wishes from the reader of that review. Now, with the opinion mining, we can distinguish the poor content from the high quality content. Like, we will basically distinguish the negative sentiments and the positive sentiments. Now, in case of the analysis or in case of movie review analysis, we have used the random forest classifier for the analysis purpose or for the prediction purpose. Now, what is random forest? Random forest algorithm takes the decision tree concept further by producing the large number of decision tree. Now, it is a random forest. Forest means the combination of trees. The approach first takes a random sample of data and identifies a key set of features to grow each decision tree. These decision tree then have their out of bag error determined, and then the collection of decision trees are compared to find the joint set of variables that produce the strongest classification method. That means in this case we have a combination of trees in order to give the strongest classification or in order to give the finalized analysis result. Now, the flowchart of the whole work is, first one is a collection of data. In case of movies reviews, we have considered the data from IMDB online movies review site. Firstly, we have collected the raw data, and after that we have pre-processor filtered that data. Like, we have movies review, that is we have sentence and we need to basically break down that sentence into bag of words. After that, the filtered data is being classified using the random forest into positive sentiment or negative sentiment, and then analyze the performance parameters. Now, the comparison parameters for the or the analysis parameters in case of random forest. First one is the accuracy rate. Accuracy rate is basically the fraction of number of correct predictions to the total number of all the cases to be predicted. That is the number of correctly classified instances, that is true positive plus true negative, that would be divided by the total number of instances in the whole data set. After that, the false positive rate. False positive rate is calculated as the ratio between the number of negative events wrongly categorized as positive, that are known as the false positive, to the total number of actual negative event, that is false positive plus true negative. Now, precision and recall. Precision is basically the fraction or retrieved document that are relevant to the query. That is the fraction of retrieved document, that is the retrieved document, fraction of retrieved document to that are relevant to that query. And recall is a fraction of documents that are relevant to the query and are successfully retrieved. The only difference here between is that in here we will fraction that with the retrieved document in case of precision, and here we will fraction that with the relevant document in case of recall. Now, the tool used in this project is Java JDK 1.8, NetBeans and Weka as an external library. Now, I am going to demonstrate you the same project into NetBeans. Now, the demonstration of the same project into NetBeans. Here, I have created one project named Movie Sentiment, and after that, I have created the two packages. One is for the classification algorithm and another one is for the graphical user interface. Now, what I will do, I will right click on the main graphical user interface file and click on the run file button. The processing of the project is going on and it will show us one main window. In that window, we can basically browse the dataset. Now, I am going to browse the dataset. That is movies dataset 1.arff. ARFF is basically attribute relational file format. Now, here is the whole data. The dataset which I have browsed is the content of that dataset is basically shown into the dataset viewer window. After that, I will click on the next button. This will give us the filtration window. In this window, what we will do is we will convert this string into the word vector, that is the bag of word. We will tokenize our sentence into words. Like you can see over here, Here I have we have the data in sentences, and we have break down that sentences into words. And what the whole data can be converted into numeric format. How? First one is the class label. Second one is the index of the word, and this one represents the frequency of that word into that particular sentence. That means first one represent the index and second one represent the count or the frequency of that particular word into that particular sentence. After that, we will click to the next button. Here we have the random forest algorithm, that is basically the combination of decision trees. The decision tree algorithm, which is by default used in case of random forest, is random tree. Now, the total number of instances in our dataset is 795, out of which 564 are correctly classified. That will correspond to 70.9434% of accuracy. Percentage of accuracy. And after that, it is showing 231 instances as incorrectly classified. 231 instances are incorrectly classified. That means the actual and the predicted values are not matched in case in 231 cases. Now we have a confusion matrix. These whole parameters like the accuracy, the precision, recall, true positive rate, false positive rate, all these are calculated from the confusion matrix. Now what does this confusion matrix represent? Confusion matrix represents the diagonal elements, that is 163 plus 395 plus 6, that will correspond to 564, that is the correctly classified instances. That means the sum of diagonal elements is equal to the correctly classified instances, which corresponds to the actual prediction basically matches with the predict the actual value basically matches with the predicted value. And the non-diagonal elements, that is 74, 27, 37, 6, 7 and 80, all these corresponds to 231. That means incorrectly classified. That is, in these cases, actual values does not match with the predicted values. All these parameters are basically calculated from the confusion matrix. That's all with this section, with this session. Thank you so much for listening.